inspire someone of God this morning. Deliver where deliverance is needed. Heal where healing is sought for. Father, encourage where one needs encouragement. Let our lives never be the same again. In the name of your Holy Son, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Put your hands together for yourself. Amen. I want to bless God for the life of Dr. Daniel Efiyes and his family. Can we please appreciate him? Let's appreciate him. I want to thank God for the leadership of this noble meeting and group, and for obeying God even with the ministry of intercession and prayer. The hardest thing to do is to intercede. It's the most difficult. Of all types of prayers, the most difficult is the intercessory, because nobody will reward you for doing it, because intercession is meant to be secret. It is not the kind of prayer that you walk in the street and everybody is seeing it. Sometimes we have gatherings that are prophetic in nature. I'm sure if you had said we're going to have some prophetic healing and deliverance shift program, the whole place would be packed. But to pray is something else. If I only look into religions all over the world, you'll agree with me that every religion prays. Every religion prays. Every religion. Every group that identifies with religion prays. So prayer is a central part of any kind of religion you find around. But the least attended meetings of every religion is the prayer meeting. Ask me why. One of the reasons is that people pray, they don't get results. So people are quite comfortable with this revival program. He knows when it comes, he'll be revived. This is a healing program. When he attends, he'll be healed. This is a financial prosperity program. When it comes, it's all about finances. They'll pray about their businesses and how to get money. And you see that thing? Oh, this is family life. So they will attend and hear messages to you. Help reshape and rebuild their families. But prayer, I also gathered that prayer is the most done activity of every religion. You can call yourself a Christian or a Muslim or a Buddhist or a Shinto or Hinduist who is not familiar with prayer. But the most least in terms of results and in terms of rewards, it's very easy for somebody to stand and preach. It is very easy for someone to pick up a microphone and start singing songs. And if you know the song, you can easily flow with the person. And if it is your favorite song, the Holy Spirit has come. But if it is not your favorite song, you'll be wondering, where is it that this song cry, where is it going to? Hallelujah. A lot of us pray, and after prayer, we don't even know whether God answered it or not, because we do not have, to some extent, physical or tangible or empirical proofs. We are expected to pray and believe that it's been answered. We are expected to pray and know that, like 1 John 5:14 says, that this is the confidence that we have in him, that when we pray according to his will, he hears us. And if we know he has heard us, then we have received of him that which we prayed for. And so, with knowledge that God heard you, without any proofs and any physical evidence, you go home anticipating or expecting that the answers will come later. Hallelujah. We are all supposed to pray, but I can tell you on authority that very few people are faithful with prayer. Amen. Apart from coming for an intercessory meeting like this, when was the last time you prayed alone? Maybe 3 hours alone. It wasn't an all night. The Bible speaks concerning Jesus. As his custom was, a great while before day, he would go to a solitary place. This is not corporate prayer. He would go to a solitary place and he would pray all night. He will pray all day. I don't know how many of us are familiar with all night prayers alone. Not Fridays, not joining a team, not church, not corporate like this, but alone. Alone. Brothers and sisters, as I take us through enforcing prophetic words over Ghana, one of the things I need for us to understand is that God's heart goes with nations. God is interested in what happens in nations. But a nation does not just happen. A nation is not just built. God first puts or raises a man forward, and that man then connects with other men. That becomes a family, and other families become a community, and communities become a nation. So if prayer is not at its foundation from the individual level, it may not be so strong at the national level. Because aside all of us coming together, we are individuals. And I thank God that God this morning has found you to stand in the gap. I didn't hear a good amen at all. But you don't know me, so you are trying to. Don't worry, God knows me. Amen. So God is interested in what happens in nations. When you study Genesis chapter 12, God called one man. His name was Abraham. He called him and he said, move out of your family, out of your country, and go to the place I will show you. And he said to him, I will bless you, and I will make your name great. appeared to him, and the angel fought with him, and he struggled for a while until he prevailed. The Bible said, Hosea said later, he said he prayed, he said he struggled with God until he prevailed because he had power with God. And that day God changed his name from a supplanter, from one that is behind, from one that pulls down, to a priest of God. His name was changed from Jacob to Israel, which is now a nation. God is interested in nations. Your prayer will influence this nation.
Amen.
Your prayer will affect this nation.
Amen.
Your prayer will change things in this nation. Your prayer will enforce the prophecies over Ghana. It shall enforce prophecies over this nation. It shall affect Africa. It shall affect the whole world. Say, oh God, I believe that my prayers will affect this nation. Hallelujah. I love it that I'm seeing a lot of elderly people. I believe that if the elders go on retirement, one of the things they have to do is just pray. They eat and pray, eat and pray, eat and pray. I'm planning to build a prayer retreat center for only the elderly. All they'll come and do, it's not to fast. All they'll come and do is to eat and pray, eat and pray, eat and pray. Hallelujah. But they have fasted enough. So if they have to go on retirement, it must include fasting. Amen. You know, in this part of Africa, we fast without a lot of wisdom. When you study the Bible, if you are a good student of the Bible, you realize that anywhere people fasted, the one we call dry, they never did anything. Even Jesus. He wasn't fasting and going to work, moving about. He went to one place, stayed there 40 days, 40 nights. Moses, Elijah, even Elijah to be moving about. They gave him spiritual food. Hallelujah. So we fast, going to work, doing other things. And then when we are growing old, the effect of not following good health laws starts catching up with us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was talking to one of my sons and I said, I live a fasted life. And I said to them, I'm not eating. He said, Daddy, the meeting I'm going for is not your food you will not eat that you do the thing on. It's God. It's how connected you are to God.
Amen.
Say, God is interested
in the welfare
of nations. Nations are on God's heart. If you're a good sociologist, you agree with me that there are certain pillars that make up a nation. The first of it is the family pillar. A nation can never come about without the root of the family. We all came from families. And when you trace us, we get to the first family God placed on this earth called the Adamic family. And I like the way Luke puts it. When you read Luke's account of the genealogy, he said, and Adam, the son of God. Thank God that every other family is named by his name because God is the foundation of all families. Hebrews chapter 3 verse 4, the Bible said, the builder of every house is a man, but the builder of all things is God. The psalmist said, except the Lord builds the house, they that will build, they will build, but it will be in vain. And except the Lord watches over the house, the watchman will watch, but it will be in vain. Because in vain we rise up early in the morning, I have put my own margin in. Traffic, get to work early so that we can work the whole day, maybe 8 hours, and then come home late and eat the bread of sorrow. Say, Father, build this nation. Hallelujah. So God is interested in nations, but the first pillar of nation is a family. The first pillar of nation building is the family system. So when you visit us, maybe God gives you the chance to visit us at the Corporate Prayer Fellowship, which meets every Monday from 5 p.m. to 7:30 at the SIC Life Mall in Makola. Our focus is to align all the pillars of society according to God's will through prayer. So when you come there, by the word of God and by fellowship and by prayer, we align all the building blocks of society. God is interested in families. Every human being's point of call or point of reference is to a family. The anthropologists say that the first 4 years of the brain's formation is by the input the child gets from his family. The neurologists say that the first 4 years, the child builds or fills half of his brain. So it means half of the things you know in your brain, you got them from your family. So if it is wrong, if it is bad, chances are that you're going to build on it. Psalm 11 verse 3, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? But this morning, as we pray, some foundations will be shaken and God will lay a new foundation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Abraham sought for a city whose builder was God. So God is interested in families. As we begin to pray, some families will receive visitation from God.
Amen.
God will send angels to families.
Amen.
The Lord's word will be sent to families.
Amen.
Listen, as we have come here to pray, if there are issues regarding your family, they will never remain the same.
Amen.
God himself will step in. He will fix the family. He will build the family. He will beautify the family. He will glorify the family. Say, I receive it.
I receive it.
As I'm preaching, I've seen angels walking too. It's like they are here on a different assignment. The second pillar of societies is what we call religion. Religion. There must be a certain worldview or belief system of the unknown, of the invisible. Of God. They believe in something. They believe God as he exists. And sometimes I say that they are worse than Satan, because the Bible says devils believe God is and they shudder. So if Satan believes God is and you say you don't believe God is, then you and Satan, who is more Satan than the other? Hallelujah. Some people have studied and studied and studied, and they say, no, everything must be empirically proven, existentially proven, scientifically proven. And what they don't even know is that God is a science. They don't know God is a science. But the little science they have, with which they prove every theory and systems and structures, they want to prove the existence of God. And they don't know that God cannot be proven. He simply must be believed before it can be experienced. Hebrews 11 verse 6, he says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. For anyone who comes to God, he must first believe that God is, and he diligently rewards those who seek him. This morning, as you have come here as an expression of your faith, you will encounter God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God must be experienced through belief. There's something that shocks me about God. The three most profound transcendental nature of God. He is omnipotent. And the word omnipotent, in my simple understanding, means this: that God who has so much power that he himself has not been able to fully use the power, because nothing or nobody or no situation has forced him to lose all. Some of us think, oh, this one is too difficult. It may be too difficult with you, but with God, all things are possible.
Amen.
Are you blessed?
Yes.
He simply says, he knows all things, omniscient. There are things God knows. us, they are for us, our children and their children. Chances are that the things you know, the things your children will know, and the things your grandchildren will know, they will just be limited, because beyond your grandchildren, there is more. 1 Corinthians 2:9, he says, the things God prepared for those who love him, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, neither has it entered into anybody's heart, but he has revealed them to us by his Spirit. This morning as we pray, there will be revelation.
Amen.
Secret things will be unfolded.
Amen.
Luke 12:2 says, there is nothing that is hid that will not be revealed. He said, under the roof, it will be held on top of the roof. As we pray, some secret things that are going on, they shall be exposed. And if they are evil, they shall cease. I said, they shall cease. I said, they shall cease. I said, they shall cease. This morning, any spirit that is hungry for blood in this nation, it shall continue to be hungry for blood, for it shall never be fed. Nobody's blood will be spilled for him to be fed. Say, in the name of Jesus, we shall mass. So religion becomes the second pillar of building a society. Everybody has a certain worldview. Everybody has a certain belief system. And everybody has a certain value system. I pray that yours will be the right one. The Bible said the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Apostle Paul says that God takes the foolish things of this world and uses it to confound the wise. What is the foolish things? It's the gospel. He said the gospel that we preach is the power of God unto those that believe, those that want to be saved. But he says to those that are wise, it is foolishness, for the preaching of the gospel is a stumbling block to the wise. Some people think they are wise, but they don't know they are foolish. Say, Father, visit our worship centers. The third is the political pillar. I'm just giving you recaps, touching on them. There's a book that will be released in this month we have entered into. The Gospel in the Marketplace. Understanding the Gospel in the Marketplace. And all these things are captured in there. So I'm citing your appetite for it by giving you just synopsis. Put the full letter note and the book comes out. You tell God we can order for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The political system. The political system. The first system God set up was the system of priesthood and kingship. For we have made priests and kings unto our God. Every child of God, the two most important roles you play on this earth, you are one, a priest, and two, a king. You have dominion. Adam, I bless you. Genesis 1, 27 and 28. He blessed them and he said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, replenish, subdue, and have dominion. Say, I walk in dominion.
I walk in
say,
dominion.
Father, any level of dominion Ghana has lost among nations in the world, as we pray, let Ghana be restored. Dominion, 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 rulership, being in charge, being in control. God rules this earth through his children, through his sons. God rules the earth through the church. When you have time, read Isaiah chapter 2, 1 to 4. All these pillars are there. He said that in the last days, even the mountain of the Lord's house shall be exalted above every other mountain. So I'm telling you, these mountains, these building blocks, these pillars that nations hang on. God is interested in politics. Some ignorant pastors say that God is not interested in politics. God is interested in politics. Romans 13, there is no authority that has been set, no power that is set, except the one which God has put in place. Whether you like it or not, you have a duty as a child of God to pray for the president of this nation. You may not like him, you may not like his party, you may not like whatever he does, you may not like his government, but as a child of God, you have a duty. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, give tribute to whom tribute is due. Duty to whom duty. Honor to whom honor. He said, owe no man nothing except love. Do you know one way we sin is by speaking against the leadership? And yet when we come to church, let's confess and say, so the whole day have not done anything. Meanwhile, you spoke ill. Say, Father, have mercy on me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We owe God a duty of we being interested in politics. And one problem I have with Christians when it comes to politics is this. We think we can only pray and change things. No. Decisions are not made with prayer. Decisions are made with involvement, using your mind, being part of the meeting, the team that make decisions. So Daniel, some Daniel is here. So Daniel did not go on his knees, oh God, change things in this nation. No! After going on his knees and praying, he will sit in the committees, sit in the meetings, sit at the teams and make decisions. Influence, listen to this. He influences decision, one, with the word of God, and two, by the will of God. So we must be involved. Churches should get up and teach members that if you don't get involved in politics, politics will continue to be dirty. Nobody will clean it up. And you find people who are clean when they get into politics, they are messed up. Because nobody is cleaning the mess in politics. How I pray that our children will be involved in politics and they shall enforce the will of God. Satan fought the political status of Adam, the Garden of Eden. He said, this guy is in charge. He rules everywhere. No, no, no. I want the status he has. I want to add it to mine. And he was able to get it. I can prove it to you. Luke chapter 4. When we read from verse 4 down, he says he took Jesus onto a high mountain and he showed him the kingdoms of this world with its glories. And he said to him, it's been given to me and to whosoever I give it. If you bow down to worship, I will give it to you. And Jesus said, I will not, because God, my Father, says I should not bow to any power. Today, if you join politics and you don't have some dirty powers backing you, some consultations, some sorcery, some witchcraft, some spells backing you, you can't do well. But the Bible said in Daniel 4:6-17, he said, this is what the watchers have said, and the announcers are making clear to us, that it is God who rules in the affairs of men. Daniel 2:21, he says, God changes the times and the seasons, and he raises one from the throne, and he puts him away, and puts another on the throne. May God visit our politics in the name of Jesus. Do you know that as I'm speaking, there are two very wicked spirits in Ghana. They don't belong to Ghana, but they have visited Ghana because of our politics, because this year is an election year. Are you aware? And I'm telling you, I'm a watchman. So watchmen, they stand by the gate and watch who enters, who doesn't. And I've seen that two evil spirits have entered. And somebody went to contract them to come. Mayanda Atika Asaya. Limba Bakata Asopratas. We declare that the scepter of the wicked shall not dwell in the land allotted for the righteous. Yeah. branches of our living. Right now, if they come and announce that 6 o'clock, nobody should go out, you have no say. You have no say. And we don't do anything about it. We are not interested in who sits in the parliament to make decisions. Very soon, ethical issues will catch up with the church. Because the church is a public place. Even the rights for the church to operate as a public place, it is given by the authority in governance. Ghana Police Church, here, if we are registered, our registered rights and authorities given to us by the registrar department, registrar general, and we operate as a church. To operate as a church, woman. Thank you. And they try to box us with non-governmental. We must be determining who rules in the land. Atebria Akasha. We must determine what happens in the nation. We must be the light. We must be the salt.
Amen.
May God help our nation. I'm delaying on this. I want us to pray. Today we must pray. Say, I'm going to pray.
Amen.
Say, Father,
give me
the spirit of prayer and the spirit of grace this morning. That's what Zechariah said, Zechariah 12:10. He said, and I will give unto the descendants of David even the spirit of grace and supplication. This morning you have both. I said you have both.
Amen.
The fourth is the pillar of education. How we socialize our children, how we train our children. Our education system is determined by our cultural system, is determined by our language. So you go to some countries, they train their children, the education system, they use the major language of the nation. But some, no way, we borrow other people's language to train our people. There's a problem with that. And today when you, I'm a Fanti, when you bring the Bible, the Fanti Bible, and want to maybe understand something from English, you see, say, under the sun, it will be nothing. What's the difference between belief and faith in fancy or dream? So our understanding of belief and faith looks the same, but they are not the same because of the translationary issues. That is why the Bible is not enough without the Holy Spirit, because He is the author and the inspirer to teach us. As we have come to intercede, may we catch from this place inspiration from the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Our education system. Before we even go into prayer, let me tell you something. There is an agenda to enforce a demonic regulation in our education system in Ghana. See, when they introduced this sex education, we stood up, people talking, and fought it. Can I tell you what's going to happen? We'll be accepted. Even though we fought it, we'll be accepted. Because there is somebody called sponsor behind it. He is a faceless image. He is using money. So in Ghana we are struggling, we need money, and all it will take is to bring this LGBTQ thing. That's a meaning you know, I will say at the back. Why wouldn't I collect them? It's like Judas selling Jesus. This man, I've worked with him, many times I've worked with him, and people want to arrest him. The Bible says he go through the crowd and nobody can catch him. Listen, the reason why Judas killed himself was not because he sold Jesus. It was because he did not expect what happened to Jesus to happen. Because Judas has a way of making money. Every situation you make money with it. They bought some perfume at Jesus' feet. He saw it, ah, master. Anyway, I said no. And I said no. And they are torn up. They went to me, they're feeding enough for. And so, at the back of his mind, it's not the enough for, he's thinking of. It's the money. Sometimes we deceive ourselves. I go to jail because of it. It's not true. Because where some of us come from to church here, I know it's not true that you come here because of Jesus. Because you pass many churches where Jesus is to get here. So it definitely has to do beyond just Jesus. Maybe even the style of worship. Maybe the music. Maybe the atmosphere. Maybe the way they make you pray. Please tell somebody, you look like a suspect. Don't mind me. It's a way of making you remember the message. Because next time you see me, you may not remember any of the scriptures I've quoted, but I can see you look like a suspect. Let's give the Lord a praise. So our education system, let me tell you something. I love to be in meetings like this because I'm an intercessor. I pray my secret. And the Lord reveals a lot of things to me. You see, the building of some special places, it starts with the notion of God. But it doesn't end with the notion of God. Even Nimrod, when he was building the Tower of Babel, he did not tell the people that building it for idols. He said, let's build it unto God. But in his mind and in his spirit, he had a clear understanding of which God is talking about. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God must rescue our education system.
Amen.
I was raised in a Methodist school. I love those days. Umpo, umpo. Despite where you stay, you must appear for worship on Wednesday. And we had students coming from Kuntu and far, far places to support. If they couldn't make it for service, they will be punished the next morning. You may be a Muslim all you like, but as long as you are a student in that school, Wednesday, you must appear in church. Because the issue is, if you manufacture the standard, the product, you have the right to write the regulations and rules.
Yes.
What is happening today? So let the government take over the missionary schools. See what is happening. Over 78% of our schools that began as missionary acts and relief systems, they are full of cult activities, demonic sects, associations that have their roots in devil worship. And we call that enlightenment. I love it the way the Jews do it. If a Jew gives birth to a child, immediately the child is 3 years old, they start teaching the child the Torah. The reason why Jesus did not use any people group, but he used the Jews, was because in life, if you want to progress and advance in knowledge, you start from the known to the unknown. And at least the Jews, the 12 Jews that followed him, they had the Torah. So if he's explaining his agenda, they can understand it better than the heathen. So the child will go through the teachings, he must commit the Torah to memory. When he turns 9 years, he starts committing the whole Torah, Genesis, all the way to Deuteronomy, into memory. By age 12, he must graduate before he's introduced to the formal system of education. So as he enters into the formal system of education, 12 years is the foundation. The number 12 is the number of governments, the number of foundations. So it's already rooted. No wonder the Hebrew boys found themselves in the university of child and Babylon. They said, we will not define ourselves with the king's meat. He said, try us on fruit and veg. The Bible said, he said, test us 10 days. The Bible said, after 10 days, they were found 10 times better. May our schools be visited. Their education system they visit. But prayer alone cannot do it. It takes a God-fearing man, God-fearing woman, heading that sphere. Church is for training, no. Church is not for coming to dance. No, church is for training. He says that go into the world, preach, teach those who accept and they believe and they accept and are baptized, they become my disciples. Teach them to become disciples like yourself. Church is for training. People don't love teaching service. They want, hey, preach, shout, professor, hey, I receive. Receive nothing. You only receive emotions, sensations. You are hypnotized. In the other point, I will go for you. In the end, all you receive is wabrele. Oh, I love this kind of meeting. I feel somebody is being provoked. Are you being provoked? When we have the privilege to advise our children, tell them these pillars and tell them you need to live your life to occupy one.
Amen.
May God visit our education system. People say every good thing comes from the West. So we have not even our mindset of the Bible has been Western. It's not true. Even the Bible is not a Western book. It's an Eastern book. And the sun rises from the East. Light comes from the East. God planted the Garden of Eden in the East. But when people were going away from God, Genesis chapter 10 and chapter 11, the Bible said, and Nimrod drove the people away from the East to the West. No wonder the problems we have. Even the way we pray is Western kind of prayer. Today, how do you see people go down their knees to pray? One of the ways I can tell you are focused is if you are determined to stay in one place for a long time, because it's not easy. When you raise prayer point, people start, let's pray for mercy. What are you saying? Mm-hmm. When we pray in the spirit, we pray better. Hey, pray for mercy. Name your sins, name your iniquities, name your transgressions, one by one. Then when you say it in tongues, say, Father, help us. Three to go. Quickly. The next pillar is the pillar known as sports and arts. All these places, God is there. God is there. Can you believe how the church would be if we have some of the best, well-paid sportsmen sitting at the feet of Jesus, listening to his word? Supporting outreach would be easy. Because OB weekly allowance is a whole decade offering put together. And look, I am soon. We need places like this. Where nobody will respect even the youth, you can just walk in and pray. Who is going to build it if there is no money? And these sportsmen are on cocaine and they are on all kinds of things. They abuse their lives. They join cults. When God can. There are people that when their children say they want to play for us, no! I want you to become a doctor. Who told you only doctors that God uses? No. You won't go there. You be a lawyer. Because who has 17 problems in there now? The world of arts. The world of arts. We frown at fashion, but who will model the beauty of Christ to the world? So the God of this world has blinded their eyes from seeing the light of the glorious gospel. Say, Father, save our business. Look at the economy, money, finances. A is a central pillar. Sikasem market. I'm sure there are some people who are not here because the company they work for has sent them somewhere. Money, 75% of our monies that move every day have contact with the Freemasons, or have contact with the cult, or have contact with the sects, the banking industries. If you want to show you are a Christian, they will find you. Collectively. So businesses that are handled by people who don't believe in God are thriving, and businesses by Christians are struggling. Is our God impotent? Is our God powerless? What is happening? We have returned to the system where Israel was in Egypt. The Bible said they sent taskmasters. Go to South Korea. 92% of those that handle the financial system, they sit in Dr. Yong Kijo's church. 92%. From the central bank to the savings and loans. So one day you can get up, call the director or call the governor and say, I need some money for an outreach in the whole community. It is not now that he's going to say, hey, you know, we need to give you. No. You put a meeting together by close of day, the money is released. No one can serve two masters, God and mammon. He will serve one and leave the other. But I read my Bible and he said, the silver and the gold is mine. And he died with a small man in Yanfor. I say it with inverted commas. Hallelujah. Amen. People can come to church, dance. When is offering time? One city. Because no one offer. But can we come to church, dance? When is offering time? Give 10,000. Because you have been prospered by this God you are praising. The gospel is free, but it takes money to send it. That's why Jesus never chose any poor man to use as a disciple. They were all successful people. Can I tell you something? The 12 disciples that followed Jesus, 10 of them were teenagers. They had their own businesses between 13 and 19. Because when the child graduates at age 12, when he's about to get his 13th birthday, they call it bar mitzvah. That bar mitzvah, the father must commit 30% of his funds to the care of the child and give him a business which he will mentor him to run. So by the time he is 7 years on the market or 6 years in the business, he knows what it means to trade. He knows what it means to do business. He knows what it means to bargain. He knows what it means to negotiate. That's why Luke 15, the younger child went to his father. If it was not the norm, the father would have said, hey, we'll come and show yourself, we'll bring our inheritance. So stay. But it was part of the culture. And then they can say, so my shaman will say, yeah, shaman will say to do. It's by the time I over old man, no, he can go. Because what do they need to say? Hallelujah. I read my Bible and I saw that he said, the good man who knows God leaves inheritance for his children and their children. He didn't say he makes his child to take care of him. He must live. So the child must also live for his child. Then it goes down, not up. The ladder of honor goes up, but the ladder of blessing comes down. So when we honor God, he blesses us. It's demonic for you to think you are taking care of your child. He grows up to come and take care of you. No, he must also take care of his children. They also take care of their children. That is the succession plan of blessings. So when Jesus was going, he released the blessings over them. I think I'm not doing bad at all. I didn't see a clap for you. The seventh one is the media and entertainment. Look, phones alone have become a hub of demonic associations. Oh, God help us. get worse. It's going to get worse. More digital stations, online stations. It's going to get worse. The print media will be out of, it will be out of sync very soon. The analog system will be out of sync very soon. Everything will become Wi-Fi. It will be closed. You can stay here. I can pick my phone. Sitting, I have a device on my phone that if I pick it on this phone that is here, I'm not transmitting, but if I pick it and sit and go on that device, the message I'm preaching now can go out to anybody in any part of the world, so long as the person has access to that device. When people pick up their phones, don't know what they are checking. Satan is priding himself and slaving people. And we are in church playing church. That's why I love necessary meetings. Hallelujah. If I sit us down now and I ask some of us, last 3 weeks, what did Pastor preach? It would be difficult to tell me. If I ask on YouTube, one of the so-called guys, what was shown last 3 weeks Wednesday? So, last week, you know, I was breaking it in heart, and the week before, no, and I was going to call him, and the one before that one, oh, I don't know, I'm going to do it. I will not be able to tell you what the preacher was. May God help us. Can we please go now? Me free my kumen, me share my wire.
Guy, then I'm telling you, who is going to me?
That God's good when He's good. Money is good. And so money is a defense. Money is a defense. Wisdom is a defense. Money too is a defense. I've heard a certain man who said, money is a defense. My brother, if you have money, you are defended. Oh, babada, 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 babada. May the Lord help us. He said, the earth is full of His unfailing love. This morning, as we pray, the love of God should flow to every house in Ghana. His mouth. He gathers the waters of the sea to jars, as Psalm 33 verse 42. Then He puts the deep into storehouses. Oh goodness. Portals are going to open. Portals that have been shut. Storehouses that have been shut. Warehouses of goodness and blessings that have been shut. As we pray, they shall open. I said they shall open. And when they open, they shall empty upon Ghana. They will empty upon our cities. They will empty upon our villages. They will empty upon our people. So let the earth fear the Lord. Let all the people of the world revere Him. In this year 2020, God will prove Himself to Ghana that He is God. He will show us that He is our God. We have no other God. Among political parties, do you know there are religions trying to push some members of the political parties to fight to be leaders so they can push their religious agenda against Christianity? It shall not stand. No weapon formed against Ghana shall stand. I said it shall not stand. Every council that looks like that of Ahithophel, it shall be overturned. That Islam has. So now they have pitched their tent. Very big tent. You say if you can't beat them, you join them. So when you join them, gradually, you start possessing. But we declare in the name of Jesus. I said, we declare in the name of Jesus. The scepter of the wicked shall not dwell in the land. Unlock them for the righteous. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High, he shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. God's shadow will cover Ghana. I said, He will cover Ghana. I said, He will cover Ghana. I said, He will cover Ghana. And He will swallow every other shadow. Yet though I walk through the valley of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, because You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they comfort me. Ghana shall be comforted. I said, Ghana shall be comforted. I said, Ghana shall be comforted. I said, Ghana shall be comforted. What nation is this that looks like an orphan? The men in it have become like women. The women like babies. But God is raising a man who shall cry unto the Maker, the lover of this nation, and he shall be comforted. Somebody's heart desire this morning. Wickedness will not be exalted. Any throne of wickedness, any seat of wickedness, any table of wickedness, it is dethroned, it is overturned, it is brought down. Come on, come on, come on. He said, the Lord foils the plans of the nations. There are many plans. In 2020, there are many plans. There are many, I'm telling you, there are many plans. Just a plan for our elections. And God has a plan for it. Satan has a plan for it. Man has a plan for it. Look around. The spirit of fear has been released. The spirit of insecurity. There is a spirit that is marshalling in this nation called terror. else. No, no, that's just a list of it. This year, in the program of the spirit world, our secondary schools and universities will experience one more pestilence and a lot of lives will perish. But because you and I are standing here this morning, something can be done. Is that because they do not retain the knowledge of their God in their minds? He led them unto leanness of soul. There is a disease. I see the disease very clear. It is like the kind that eats people's flesh up, and it eats up their flesh and drinks their blood. They will say they have discovered a certain disease in our schools and in our universities, that when you are infected by, you start growing lean and weaker, because that spirit is eating up. But we stand in the name of Jesus. We declare the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, it shall not stand. And that is one of the plans, that one of the spirits that has been contacted all the way from India into this country has come to do. But who is he who speaks a word and it comes to pass? When the Lord has not commanded to subvert a man to his cause, the Lord disapproves. Say, I disapprove. Let me finish the text. Oh, you're going to pray. Hallelujah. He said, I saw for a man. He didn't say, I saw for men. So if I can get one person to pray with me, something will happen. If two of you shall agree, cutting forth any matter in prayer, my Father in heaven shall do it. Amen. See, our prayers are working. Verse 11. He said, but the plans of the Lord, Makoba Asha, he said, he thwarts the purposes of the people. This day, as we are praying, any man or woman who has a purpose or plan against the progress of this nation, let it be thwarted. Let it be thwarted. Let it be altered. Let it be canceled. He said, blessed is the nation. He said, but the plans of the Lord shall stand firm forever, verse 11, and the purposes of his heart through all generations. Satan will not capture our children. He will not capture our grandchildren. He will not capture our mothers and fathers. The Lord will still be their God. He will lead them in the light, in the name of Jesus. I love it the way God said it, even to David, Psalm 89, verse 20. I found my servant David with my holy oil of Allah anointed him. He said, I will be with him. He said, even if his children sin against me, I will not judge them because of my covenant with you. The Lord will save our nation. I said, he's saving our nation. Ghana shall be saved. Do you know that one of the prophecies, Prophet Amwaku, gave three profound prophecies. Two have been fulfilled. One is yet to be fulfilled. He even prophesied in 1983, coming nearby. He prophesied. He prophesied. He prophesied military regime. He prophesied it. He prophesied that there will be a military regime that will change the sphere of politics in Ghana, and God is going to use a young man, blah, 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 blah. And he said, before that young man dies, he shall preach the gospel. So there's a prophecy on J.J. Rollins that he will preach the gospel. If the military came, then the other one too must what? Don't be surprised that one of these days when he visits, pray, Ghana ministry, he said, give me mic. Then he will raise his hands. Hallelujah. He said that a revival will come through the nation and it will raise Ghana as the light of Africa. Before we leave, I'll give you a prophecy about Ghana. I'm seeing a few years from now, the two major political parties, they will no more be in reign. And why there is going to be a change has already happened. This return back to what the year of return has opened a door for a young political leader who has reconnected to his roots. And I see in the realm of the spirit that is bringing an ideology and a philosophy that will appeal to a lot of the youth. And I've seen when it was election time, all the youth voted for him. in them. He that is sent of God speaks the word of God, for God gives him the spirit without measure. And what he says comes to pass. I didn't come to entertain you. I came to speak the mind of God. But I pray that some of you will not be dead by then, so that the answer to your prayer, you will see it. Like Simon, he said, God has prevented me from dying because he has made my eyes to see the consolation of Israel. And he began to bless baby Jesus. He said, you be the savior of the world. You will rule your people. And through you shall all the ends of the earth rejoice, for the glory of the Lord shall be revealed. He chose for his inheritance. From the heaven, and the Lord looks down and he sees all mankind. From his dwelling place, he watches all who live on earth. He who forms the hearts of all, who considers everything they do. No king is saved by the size of his army. Sometimes we think the strategies and the plans and the meetings that parliament is having will save us. No! Chariots and horses are prepared for the day of battle, but only the counsel of the Lord. Is of the Lord. 13. But the eyes of the Lord are on those who fear him. Oh, the Lord shall vindicate his children. As you have come here to pray, the Lord will hear your prayer and he will open the doors.
Because there is one blood.
pillar that speaks against every other pillar. It's called the blood of Jesus Christ. He says it is sprinkled and it speaks better than things. Say, Father, this afternoon, as we pray, hear the cry of this nation. Release your mercy upon Ghana. Let the mercies of the Lord come upon Ghana. Let the mercies of God locate Ghana. In the name of Jesus, let the mercies of the Lord come upon Ghana. In the name of Jesus, say, Father, have mercy. Say, oh Lord, show Ghana your mercies. nation. May the Lord have mercy on this nation. He said, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy. But this afternoon, you and I are calling on our Father. Have mercy on this nation. For a nation that has no mercy will experience doom. Have mercy. Have mercy on Ghana. Have mercy on Ghana. Lord, if you have given a new Africa, then have mercy on this new Africa. Have mercy. Have mercy for the sins of our leaders, for the sins of our fathers, for the sins of our mothers, for the sins of the children, for our sins. Have mercy. Have mercy on us. For the sins of leadership, for the sins of the inhabitants of the land. Have mercy.
Instruction.
houses and same food. For I will take them back into the days of Egypt when I sent my Joseph. So this one is not prayer matter. This one is action matter. If you have some land somewhere lying down, you're fighting litigations over it, plant something. Let's go into agriculture. Let's plant, let's hold. And you know, within this prophecy, God has an agenda to make Ghana fruitful with fruits and foods. That when this famine comes, nations around us shall come to Ghana to buy.
Amen.
I can't understand why we have cocoa. Eh? We have cocoa. Please listen to me. We have cocoa. And one director who mans the department that controls cocoa affairs, he alone can have so much money, build so many houses, have a lot of cars. And the cocoa farmer who plants and farms, even bicycle tycoon, living injustice. To him, much is given, much is required. There's so much injustice in the land. It will get us a free education soon. Computerized system will select a rich man's child's certificate. It's only by why are this rich man in Ghana? These are things some of us are involved in. You have a church member calling you home, you pay get 8. Computer now follow, or we could have 33. Just as everyone, One man is eating what belongs to hundreds who are hungry. And yet, that one man doesn't need what he is spending. And the quote scriptures like, as for the poor, you have them always with you. When you just, Jesus said, when you see the detestable thing, the abomination in the Holy of Holies, in the holy place, at the altar area, to know the ends of the times have come. Say, Father, this afternoon, as I pray, I call on your righteousness, in all our sectors, our development sectors, our manufacturing sectors, our ruling sectors, decision-making sectors, religious sectors, family sectors, let righteousness, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain.
Ascendancy,
people begin to become God they shall be morally incurable. But when righteousness reigns, when righteousness comes, say, Father, let righteousness reign. I went to pray with one of the leaders of one of the major denominations in Ghana. The man, some of you may know the story. The man is not in a good state, even though he's improving. He used to be the leader of one of the denominations in Ghana. Somebody desiring to sit in the seat he sits in took him to some powers. This church, all of them are reverend doctors, went through the same institution, Trinity. They were all teaching the same department. They teach us, preach to us, profess the same Christ. But because of the seat, they could not. They wanted to kill him, but he took prayer. He went into coma many times, flown out of the country, brought back. It is not God's judgment, though. Somebody has set up evil fire against him. Church, church, church. You have people sitting in church. One leg is white, the other is black. Church. And we are deceiving ourselves. I asked myself, why is that we don't see the power that Peter and Paul were seeing? We preach better messages than them. I'm telling the truth. Peter couldn't speak proper Greek. His Greek was broken Greek. Broken, koine, broken Greek. People preach in some of the classic English. When it comes to Richard, our preachers, they prepare well and preach. One day Peter was teaching something fallacious. Paul heard it. Paul was angry. He wrote him a letter. Peter said, Paul, I know, as for you, you are a good teacher, so forgive me. It's in the Bible. I will not see the power. It says that we deny the power. We deny the power. He said, you people set the scriptures because you think in them you have your liberty. But I, that the scriptures point to, you have denied. People are following principles, no personal relationship. If God chooses not to give to us, he's still God. So it's not him giving to us that makes us to know he's God. He is on his throne. He lives alone by himself. Let Ghana hear this. Sin flows from the church. No wonder he says, when the Son of Man comes, you begin judgment from the house of God. He said, the days are not short. In Luke chapter 18, he said, if the days are not short, when the Son of Man comes, will he even find anyone with faith? Anyone with faith? We are not teaching human philosophies and ideologies. True relationship and intimacy with God is lost. From the pulpit into the people. Carnality, I hear a man. We think we are familiar with God. Have mercy on us. May the Lord have mercy. He said because the people have kicked God out and they have not made God their focus. He said, even when they plant, it shall not germinate. And when they keep their fruits, their harvest, into the storehouse, I will break into the storehouse and rebels shall eat them up. And when they keep their silver in their baskets, it shall be missing. Yeah, there is a prophecy on Ghana. Do you know that Ghana prophetically can mean God has a new Africa? Because Ghana is the eye of Africa. There are other countries on the Greenwich Meridian, on the gateway, but Ghana is positioned very right on it, the center. Prophetically, only two nations, and I'm saying brackets, I was with Jehovah, Ghana and Israel. Brackets, I am with you, but they are crying. At least if God is not good and is not merciful, that alone tells you we are unique. Look at our gold. Look at our oil. Look at the minerals. And we are still struggling. Calidia, Esraso, they have oil for the next 300 years. If they decide not to even extract more oil or process the next 300 Israel so desert. But he doesn't lead us in the desert. He leads us in the green pastures. Look at Ghana, Ufiako, Tamania. A coin change in a green. People are struggling. People can't even afford 3 square meals a day. Go Dubai, stressful. I was there sometime, stressful. Go safari, go ski. Stressful bar. And so the economy is so buoyant. All because Sigana Elba, a whole people too. God have mercy on us.
Amen.
When sin is in a nation, it can never be exalted. Ansana, businessman, obey you soon. Not system, whatever your business, I am corrupt. Because there are practices in education system right from the primary state that is inherent of corruption. Politics among ministers of God in the bureau. Why will we see power? How are we going to see power? All the politicians, over 68% of them are in church. They belong to churches. Let just 60%, let even 51% of them do the right thing, the nation will move forward.
Amen.
Let righteousness come as a rain upon our nation. Let righteousness rain upon the nation. If the clouds be full of rain, it will empty itself. Let righteousness. Das ist success in Israel. His kingdom stretch from shore.
Yeah.
That's injustice. You see the perspectives? I'm not sure if I'm in the office. Number one, almost 7 of them. Before the queue, number one. Number one, I said that they join the queue.
Perpetrate evil. I will not support.
And that's where Ghana is getting to. I'm saying this with my eyes open. A time is coming in this nation, the church will struggle because I see the light being passed through it. We will start, oh, we're waiting for God, we're waiting for God. It could be a genuine desire. But beyond waiting for God, I see darkness. Intercessors, so it must be normal to hear things like this. If you are an intercessor in a political lead by us, there's something wrong with you. Because you must be comfortable no matter who leads and supports. 1 Timothy 2, verse 1 down. He says, I beg you, that hands, holy hands are lifted in supplication, prayer, intercession, and thanksgiving, making for all men, except those, especially those in authority. So this is the will of God. So if I belong to party A, and party Q's person is leading us, once is the will of God, I must support. Why can't Ghana have a long-standing agenda that every party that comes will continue from where it has reached? Now, we pause here. Let me start my own. So we have unfinished work. Work in progress. All because the spirit of selfishness and greed, no love. Someone could be contracting even a business on behalf of the nation, is thinking about his commission. So even if the decision will go against the nation, he doesn't care, as long as it's 15%, 20% is coming to him. May the Lord have mercy on this nation. Our hearts are covered when canker, decay. Today's intercession is different. It's been clouded with canker and decay. Mothers and fathers have children, and they want their children to go in for a particular marriage that is going to be beneficial, not going to be the will of God. The Lord is here. I said, the Lord is here. I seen an angel walking from the back. He's just facing up with a sword. He said, my sword is my word, and I'm ready to release it against anything that shall rise. Hebrews 4:12. He said, the word of God is quick. It is sharper than every double-edged sword. It's able to pierce the soul. He's able to separate the soul from the spirit and separate the bone from the marrow. It's able to even discern the intent in a man's heart. I release the sword of the spirit into your home. Any power that is rising from your background, standing against your progress in Christ, let the word of God severe it. Successes like this. So you stand and bridge the gap. You stand and determine righteousness. The Lord is speaking to me. There are 13 people here. Prophecies hanging over your life are being enforced. They are being enforced. They are being carried out. They shall happen in your lifetime before you die. There are specific and personal heart desires you are praying for years. It looks like it's not coming to pass. Like you are becoming weak, but the Lord said, even in your lifetime, you shall see the fulfillment. Thank you. You shall see the fulfillment. Sing it. Na me bom. agenda, being worked out against this nation, through politics. As I pray, I cancel it.
I cancel it.
I cancel it. Say in the name of Jesus, any agenda that is being resolved in politics that will bring darkness over Ghana, may there be disagreement. No conclusion. No conclusion. No conclusion. No conclusion. Say, Lord, I said confusion in every agreement to bring darkness over this land.
In the name of Jesus.
Bible said, you shall decree a thing, and it shall be established, and the light of God will shine on your path. I pray this afternoon with you. Accomplished. He wants his agenda carried out. Let him prosper. in Psalm 1 it says, and whatsoever he does shall prosper. As you have come here to pray, if there is any need you carried here, you are not taking back that gift. I love God's mass ministration anointing. Sicknesses are melting in this atmosphere. As I said, sicknesses are melting in this atmosphere. There is a particular lab report, some symptoms that are visiting, but you want it to become negative. The Lord has taken it out of order. Some sicknesses, it comes with age, it comes with old age. And Jacob was well stricken in years, but his eyes never went dim. With long life will I satisfy thee, and I'll show you my salvation. I curse premature death. I curse premature death. Children yet, I speak over your life, you will live to see them in the name of Jesus. For the blessings of the Lord are even unto a thousand generations. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. If in any way there is a plan to take your life out of you, I demand on your behalf in the precious name of Jesus. Against premature death, against fire outbreak, against arm robbery, against any attack, your heart shall not fail, your lungs shall not fail, your kidneys shall not fail, your internal organs shall not fail, your eyes shall not fail, your waist shall not fail, your body shall not fail. Who has the final say? Jehovah. Even some of you need to know your intercessors. The oil for intercession is gone down. The Lord said, I'm refilling. The Lord said, and I will speak even by your own ear and tell you what to pray about. Without corporate meetings, may everybody here with a new heart to stand in the gap, receive an open ear. Spiritually, may your ears open. Amen. Physically, may your ears open. Amen. Sometimes I'll be lying down, and the Spirit will come to me and say, come, follow me. And I will follow the Spirit. And take me into a meeting. And I will hear what they are planning. You only hear what is being said on the news, but there is more to what is being said on the news. Something concerning, I have a different view about it. May God bring you to that level. Where you can hear evil before it is concluded upon, and you can block it and stop it in the name of Jesus. One day Gehazi was with Elisha, and the enemies were coming. Gehazi was crying. That today we are finished. Elisha said, we are not finished. He said, my master, you don't even have a plan to protect yourself. How are we going to find this man? And I said, he laid his hands on him and he prayed for him. Lord opened his eyes, and his eyes opened, and the man saw. He said, hey, my master, why are you cool, sir? Listen, from today, as an intercessor, what people will make noise about, you shall be quiet about, because you know the end.
Thank you, Lord.
Sasasi ni dani butu, emi butu. Yeah. it in this place. And he said, I want my faithful ones to eat them. And as they started tasting it, it was bitter on the lips, but sweet even in the belly. And the Lord said, I will recondition your inward parts, and I will give you burdens from the womb that you shall labor and give birth to. Listen to this. As Zion unveiled, she brought forth a man child. Who has heard such a thing? Can a nation be born in a day? Can a people be gathered in a day? It is not possible, but as soon as from today your travail shall bring forth peace in this nation, it shall bring forth progress in this nation, it shall bring forth development in this nation. See, one of the tools the devil is using to fight the nation, division amongst Christians. Somebody hates another. I'm talking about hatred. 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 Hatred, oh, hatred. I believe in prophetic revelations because I'm prophetic myself. But how can one prophet see something about another prophet and cause havoc and wish his downfall?
Upon that person.
says, he shall live long.
Amen.
Oh, my goodness.
Amen.
My goodness. There are some people, when they touch you, your life starts reducing. There are others, when they touch you, your life is prolonged.
Amen.
And the Lord said, I've made you one of such.
Amen.
Can you stretch your hand towards him? Who wants to enjoy long life? Let's pray into this anointing. As you fuel this anointing, you will enjoy from the anointing. Ask the Lord that the blessing he has placed on his servant, on his son, you will get a portion. Something that is connected to you shall get a portion. Lift up your voice and begin to pray.
His grace be upon our lives. In the name of the Lord Jesus,
I am closing. Pray, release that blessing. Release that blessing. Release that blessing. Release that blessing. Even a shoes have been removed, and they are putting the sandals at his feet. And the Lord said, I have a new assignment for you. It is of glory. Receive it right now. I command peace in your house. I command peace at your workplace. I command peace in your relationship. I command peace in your family. You are immune against disaster. The arrows that fly by day, they will not come near you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Ushers, are you here? In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. No arrow shall touch you. No arrow shall touch you. Every fiery dart of the enemy, it shall be blocked for your sake. And I pray the blessing of the Lord upon your life. When you start to pray, it shall never be hindered. Amen. It shall be smooth. Amen. It shall go unhindered. Amen. The Lord shall hear you. Amen. Say, Father, I thank you. Handing over the microphone, but the Lord said, bless. Let this hand be the hand of God. Amen. And be upon your shoulder. Thank you, Jesus. For the garment shall be upon his shoulders. You somebody, your energy will not fail. 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 In the name of Jesus. But so in here, you should my own team. Shall no more be a portion. He said that the strength of the agent shall be like the strength of a mighty man. Let your strength be renewed. He said, you renew my strength. generation of souls that have not been saved in this nation. Lift up your voice and pray.
Father, we pray, Lord, this time, even for souls that are not saved in this nation, we pray, Lord.